Hey, what's going on guys? Welcome back to another brand new Android Studio tutorial, and today in this video I will show you that how to save data inside the Android app. So in the past tutorials we have been learning about how to simply just get a data from the edit text and save it inside the string, and we have a little bit idea about passing the data and something like that. So we discussed about saving the data inside a string, which we actually catch it from the edit text or something like that. And if you're using the string, you know that the data will be destroyed once the application is closed, and when it turned back again there will be no that data saver. So in this video I will show you that how to actually save data and retrieve it whenever we actually record it. So in this video we are going to use a method called SharedPreference, and using the SharedPreference we can able to save data inside the Android app and retrieve it whenever it is actually required. So using the SharedPreference we can save the data like the username and password of the user who is actually logged into the app for the first time. You can also use the SharedPreference to check whether the app is launching for the first time in that Android device, and also something like that. And also the SharedPreference is used to save the settings of the Android app, like we have seen that you can just turn on the push notification, and you can simply set this theme, and you can set that theme in, and something like that. And it's all done by the SharedPreference, and we can see that if we set a particular theme inside an Android app, then whenever we opening it again the theme will be same as what we have saved, and it is all done by the SharedPreference. So in this video I will be talking about how to actually use the SharedPreference inside the Android Studio, and we will be creating an Android app in the next video. So implementing the SharedPreference is really easy. All you have to do is simply get a call, the get preferences or the get shared preferences, and using that you can write the data into the shared preference and call it whenever we actually require. So at the time I'm recording this video, the shared preference have two different type of modes. One is the private, one is the multi-process. So in the private mode you can save the data as a XML file inside your application which is not able to access from the other applications, and the multi-process is a kind of thing that the server data can be accessed outside from the application. Okay, so now let's go to the Android Studio and let me show you an example that I'm going to do. And this is what we are going to do in the next tutorial. So as you can see here we have a edit text and two buttons, one is save and one is load. And the idea is going to be like I'm going to enter something inside this edit text, and once it is entered I'm going to click the save button, and once it is saved I'm going to remove the text from here, and clicking the load will be bringing the text back what we have saved. And that's the idea, simply logical idea. So in the next tutorial I will show you that how to actually implement it inside the main activity. So stay tuned, thanks for watching, and hope to see you in my next video.